Non so qual è quello bianco laggiù. Il problema è che devo guardare là così. Lì.
Colpo del matto, porta Miller in pole position per il Gran Premio in Argentina. Prima dentro, gas a martello e andiamo. E parte inevitabilmente bene Jack Miller. Il secondo posto sul podio di Danilo Petrucci. Danilo Petrucci che cerca di entrare.
Danilo!
Petrucci di nuovo. Danilo Petrucci l'ha fatto. L'attacco di Miller, in staccata. Buongiorno, buongiorno, che bello tornare a parlare di moto, cominciare a sentire di nuovo il profumo.
We are so happy of listening to talk about MotoGP. And this is so good because we are going to be hearing about a beloved Italian team. It's very good to welcome here in the Sky TV studios. It's so good to welcome here the unveiling of this bike, which is the Ducati of the Pramac team of this year, that will be driven by Jack Miller. Hi, Jack. How are you doing? Welcome here. And Pecco Bagnaia, Francesco Bagnaia, world champion of Moto2. He is now in MotoGP. He is really satisfied for what he did last year. The leader of this team, the team manager, is Francesco Guidotti, a historical character in the MotoGP world. He raised so many champions, and he was a crucial part of this Pramac project that has been doing so many important things for many years. I will be sitting here There is the final countdown now, 4 minutes and 42 seconds to unveil the bike. You can follow this beautiful event in the Sky website, also in the Pramac Racing Team, Lamborghini website, and in other Facebook pages. Let's now delve into the long history of Pramac Team. The roots of this history are date back to a long time ago, and they are now a reference for everybody. Yes, in fact, in the last years we did some things with other satellite teams. In fact, Ducati helped us in this process. There was this connection in the last 4, 5, 6 years. We worked very hard, and we tried to put all the material available to let drivers like Iannone and Petrucci grow and develop. So we want to keep on doing like this. We really hope to reach good results in the future. And some other people decided to join our team. Let's now see the history of Pramac. And the debut was in 2002. The 18 podiums, 2 victories and 4 poles. Last year's 235 points, 1 podium and 1 pole. We should highlight the great adventure of last year of Jack Miller. And in the upper part of this screen, with K numeri, what numbers we have, we need to underline that they are, Pramac is the first team of independent teams. And as Mr. Guidotti was saying, you have been the trailblazers. At first you were team juniors and then team experiments, but then you developed a model in which now many people inspire. Are you satisfied of your winter season? Let's now start from Jack Miller.
It's been a good winter, but you know, now that part is the easy part. Now comes the hard part with the racing, but I'm excited. You know, the teams work really hard through the winter. Ducati's work really hard through the winter, and you know, stepping to the 2019 bike has been a big jump for me, and I'm enjoying it a lot. So now I'm looking forward to finally starting to race.
Senti anche tu quella voglia che a un certo punto nell'inverno ci prende.
Don't you notice that willing you have? Because okay, we need to stop to do tests. We need to travel again and do racing.
Once the testing's over, you know, now it really feels like racing. Already on the last day of testing, you say, ah, I wish we was already on the Friday, you know, of racing, but. Now it stops, and we can really let the results do the talking. You know, the test is special because you can do the lap time through the whole day, but when it comes to the 40 minutes and you need to make the lap time or, you know, come into the race, that's when it really counts.
Eh certo. Senti, Pecco, ti ha abbracciato una nuova famiglia. La prima sensazione a Valencia.
A new family embraced you. The first feeling in Valencia was extraordinary. Are you okay? Do you feel good? We have 1 minute and 20 seconds to answer this question. Do you feel good in this team? Then we will go into detail to unveil the bike. Was it below or up or above your expectations? It was above my expectations. In fact, this year we started with a real MotoGP mentality. Especially, I tried to understand what to do, what I could have done in these 6 days of test. In Malaysia, we were very competitive in time attack. We were second, actually. While in Qatar, we tried to do something more about the race pace. We did a simulation of race pace, and I have to say that I'm more satisfied of the Qatar test because we had some problems at the beginning, and we managed to solve them. I have so many questions to pose to you. I would say that we can pose this question after the unveiling. You can probably show the bike in 30 seconds. So you can, okay, you can place yourself in this position when the special effects of this unveiling will start. You will say, no, don't worry. Don't worry for the mic. Now we unveil the bike and then we will set up the mic again. So, 10. 9 seconds, 7 seconds to the unveiling. Wait for it, because we have a special effect, so now the heartbeat is so strong. I wish you the best for this MotoGP season with this Ducati Desmo 16 that we are about to unveil. Are you ready? Okay, then go.
Ecco la creatura.
Here we go with the creature with which Pramac Team will race this year, driven by Jack Miller, who will be driving the version 2019, the most updated one, the official one, and Francesco Bagnaia, who will drive the very good bike of last year. And then we are going to talk with Francesco of the fact that maybe the differences are quite slight between one bike and another. We should talk a bit about this bike and all the items and features. It's not surprisingly, here you have the Lamborghini brand and the symbol that was stuck there just 1 minute before we went into air. We went on air, sorry. And this is.
Perché questa moto, di fatto, il disegno di questa moto.
This is due to the fact that the design of this bike is from Lamborghini. Yes, in fact, last year we started this sort of partnership with a presentation at the Lamborghini headquarters, and also thanks to the manager of the style center at Lamborghini. In fact, this manager is loves motorbikes and loves Ducati. In fact, these two brands are very similar among each other. Lamborghini was happy to go and is still happy of collaborating with us, and we welcome there at our home. So it looks like the job is a very good one. And I know that this Y letter in the side is a symbol that is very important to Lamborghini. We should take a narrow look. For example, Francesco, if you want to turn around the bike, you can show our public how this bike is made, how it is designed. I would take the chance that Francesco speaks Italian to talk about the right side of the bike, and the left side is going to be shown by Miller. Why do you use this button? This is the key button. It is the button that turns off the engine. This is the leverage when you need to go neutral, when you don't need any gear in. Then you have, okay, you have the throttle and the brake. And now the first gear is up, and now what happens? With this new mechanism, the first gear is down. Yes, you're wrong. I was wrong, sorry, you were right. With this new system, the first gear is down. Let's now take a look at the left side. Why do you use these buttons? Do you use them a lot during the race? What are they?
For your power levels through the race, you know, when the tire starts to go, you start to go through the maps on that one. Normally green is engine brake. We only use that one for the engine brake. Yellow is fuel mapping if we are on the limit.
Certo.
And then pit lane.
Okay, la velocità per limitare la velocità
exactly,
in pit lane,
exactly.
Nei box.
And, this one is TC, but for me, I never normally touch it so much.
Non lo tocca il traction control, tu lo tocchi? Lo scopriremo andando avanti. Sarà il momento di correre.
Parlo we will going to discover later on what this button is needed.
Sulla sinistra, in modo
this register, this button on the left is to adjust the distance of the brake leverage. If the driver wants to have the leverage closer to the throttle, you can adjust the distance of the leverage, and you can do the same with the clutch. But the most interesting thing today, apart from the tests of Qatar, is that this bike has a very good style. We have talked about Mitya Borg, who is responsible for style at Lamborghini. He put all his passion in this bike and in Ducati in general. I would say that we can listen to his speech now.
First of all, welcome here to the Centro Stile of Automobili Lamborghini. It is the place,
benvenuti
the
al Centro Stile Lamborghini, è un posto in cui cerchiamo di creare e forgiare il futuro della Lamborghini. Questo è il posto in cui progettiamo la Lamborghini del futuro. È stato davvero
my team, for myself, because we are also big fans of MotoGP. So when the idea came last year, when I was visiting Qatar, the MotoGP race, I was, you know, feeling the passion that also, you know, that is going around. And I have seen also Pramac Ducati as a special team. So it was already born the idea to kind of connect the design DNA and Pramac Ducati emotion. So we have successfully presented last year one dedicated bike for Jack Miller and one dedicated bike for Danilo Petrucci. And they were both designed with the Lamborghini spirit, using the Y shape, the Y shape, that is so typical for Lamborghini. If you think about front lights and tail lights of Lamborghini, there's always this Y shape that is quite significant. It is born by the hexagon that Marcello Gandini designed back then in the 60s and 70s on famous Lamborghinis like the Lamborghini Marzal or the rear mesh of the Lamborghini Miura. So it is a part of the Lamborghini history. And we have used now for the new livery that we will not only have for one dedicated race, no, the new livery for Pramac Ducati is for all the season. So we have combined the colors of the team with that kind of hexagon Y idea from Lamborghini design. Since we have seen the fantastic result of the bike of Mugello of last year, one bike was black with that yellow Y and the other bike was yellow with that black Y on top. So they were both using the opposite kind of color combination. It was looking so cool on the track. And we have decided to take that spirit and to do a new interpretation, but this time to use the traditional color of the racing team of Pramac Ducati. So we took the blue, the red and the black, and we have combined this around this kind of Y shape, Y shape, that we have put it on the side of the motorcycle. We gave a lot of dynamic to the lines, so there's one line really like leaning forward on top of the tank, and the other line is really dynamic on the side fairing, and this is, as a Y shape, is giving a lot of dynamic to the motorcycle. So I hope that our livery is giving 1% on the success, hopeful the success of Pramac Ducati this year. So I cross the fingers for this. Okay, Pramac Ducati, in bocca al lupo per questa stagione.
Tocca rispondere qua con un crepi.
We need to answer. Well, when you say in bocca al lupo in Italia, is good luck, and you answer crepi il lupo. So good luck, everybody. It's very interesting to notice that the Y letter is inspired to the hexagon of Marcello Gandini. He was one of the most important and talented designers of Italian cars. And I would say that having the signature of Gandini in motorbikes is a very good thing. We can now take our seat again and we can chat a bit about your new Ducati. Let's now start from Francesco Guidotti. Let's now talk about this first test, the pre-season test, and also the test after the last year championship. Jack Miller was already racing for you, then Pecco arrived. And the most important curiosity is when a rookie driver arrives, you still have some doubts or what? You bet on Bombagnaia, but then it's up to him showing you that the bet was right. We were convinced of the choice we made. But you realize that the change of category is really stressful for the driver. In Francesco's case was a lower stress, but because he managed and he knew how to drive this moto since the beginning. Obviously, he needed to adjust some settings, but I think that we solved the last doubt we had, that could make the difference in the first part of the season. How did you find the bike? It is easier to drive rather than you thought, because you drove it in 2016. You drove a Ducati in 2016, but you were not going fast. But at the end of the test, you had to push as much as possible. Do you think that they are like bombs? Do you think that they are embarrassing bikes that are so powerful and they cannot be managed? I think the same, but the weight is slightly higher than Moto2, while power is the double of Moto2. So I think that it is incredible the way you brake, the way you accelerate, but I have to say that the feeling was good since the beginning. At the end of the day, the bike is very, very easy to drive because I established a good relationship with her. I think that having a good feeling with what you drive is really makes a difference. Jack Miller switched from the last year bike, which did a great performance, to this year bike, the last version, the last edition of Ducati. And he is the official driver at Prama team. Did you notice some differences? Are there great differences compared to last year? Because you really did a great leap forward, a step forward from a technological point of view. What do you think about it?
It was many, many different areas, you know. Nothing really was the same, you know. You think 2 years, not much can change incredibly, you know. The bike from the outside looks similar, but it felt like a completely different bike in a good way. The bike is really, I feel the areas that we lacked on the older bikes, they really worked on it, and, you know, in terms of turning, acceleration, the new bike was incredible. And it's just getting better and better, especially with the Michelin tires. I feel the latest bike really works so well with the Michelin tires. It uses the best advantage of the Michelins, and I think for the races especially, it can be the biggest thing. And of course, you know, being the number one rider in the team, let's say, at the moment, it's a nice feeling. But of course, you know, with a rookie coming in and always pushing, it's you know, it's a good motivation for me as well.
Does he look as a strong? Ho parlato in inglese, ma tu hai già la traduzione. Ti sembra un rookie forte?
Do you
questo?
Think that he is a very strong rookie?
Definitely, I think we can take home rookie of the year, you know. But he has some good competition in this area in terms of Quartararo and Mir coming in, you know, also on really strong material. So I think in general, you know, the championship this year is going to be so close with the older guys that are still there, and then also the young guys coming in, they're all going so fast. All of the rookies, you know, are so fast. So it's going to be a great year of racing.
Ricordiamo che Jack Miller, possiamo anche tornare ai numeri che stavamo vedendo.
We have to underline some figures. Jack Miller has a special history in terms of rankings and figures. He was very young when he started. He was born in 1995, 121 races, 7 victories, 11 podiums, 650 points in his career, and many poles. He switched directly from Moto3 to MotoGP, and it was an amazing case. Everyone was really impressed. I figured out that it was not so easy for him switching from Moto3 to MotoGP. Instead, Pecco Bagnaia switches from Moto2 to MotoGP. In MotoGP, he is world champion. And what's the feeling between you two guys? Do you collaborate? You are two rivals? What happens in MotoGP? Is there an atmosphere in which rivalry is very, very strong? With Luca last year, it was a different job. We helped each other in races that were important to the final ranking of the World Championship. We were rival because we wanted to pass the everyone wanted to pass the other. In MotoGP, I think it's different because everyone needs to do a lot of very hard work, and with the official bike, the driver, the rider has a further job, an additional job. I think I have to adjust to the bike while the other guys are trying new parts to arrive till the end of the season. Obviously, it will be a great experience. I hope that we can collaborate with Jack in the weekends, but in the test, it's more difficult. I would like to see some figures about you. Let's see. You were born in 1997, you recently turned 22, 105 races, with 105 races you are quite expert driver, 23 podiums, 751 points and 7 pole position and 1 world championship last year in Moto2. Francesco Guidotti, the new riders who arrive in MotoGP need to deal with different factors that were not included in the previous championship they competed in. Yes, for sure. The electronic part in Moto2 doesn't exist. It is a very is it a difficult part? Electronic electronic is very difficult. It's the double of job you need to perform, more than the technical part. But at the end of the day, we noticed that in tests we were not lagging behind as everyone expected. In the electronic part, we tried to adjust as much as possible. I think that my team is a vanguard team. I would say that they are very professional, and also in terms of work, they know every single point, every single part of the bike. They are really experienced mechanics, and I think they were really supportive in this phase. You performed some tests, some super tests throughout the winter. Can I have a final balance of these tests? In Qatar, you worked less than the others in the fast lap. We noticed that you were working more on the long run. You were both working on the race pace. Jack, are you satisfied of your test? Is it a positive test you did?
In Qatar, I feel we made a step with that, but both tests, you know, this year also being not very easy with only having two tests rather than the traditional three tests. So 9 days, we're down to six. So this was strange, you know, but of course we've been working a lot on the race pace. In Malaysia was okay, but just still adapting to the new bike, we weren't quite there. But then in Qatar, I was really, really happy with it. And I have to say, also for Pecco, you know, coming in this year with only having 6 days test and then trying to do everything already after the first test, after the winter, the body is sore, everything's sore. So. He did really well in Malaysia to really get through that test and try to cram as much testing as we could in such a short amount of time this year.
C'è stato un test dal quale siete tornati secondo e terzo come miglior team.
There was a test in which you finished second and third in Malaysia. Midotti was so happy. He was playing trumpet in the road, down in the street. Yeah, that was. Maybe it came too early that moment. Obviously, it's always good seeing that your drivers are fast at the beginning, at the first test, but it raises the bar of expectation. So in this moment, we should rather keep the bar down, not to have great expectations. They have to, drivers have to be calm. From a mediatic point of view, because maybe then you arrive at the first race of the championship and you don't perform so well. So, well, I would say that now that we are being listened to from so many people worldwide, we could address a thought to our friend, and we want to say hi to our friend. Fonsi Nieto is their coach, he's the coach of the team. He had a post-operation problem, so he's now trying to recover from this illness, from this problem, so we want to be supportive with him.
Noi a voi per la stagione che
good luck to all of you guys for the coming season. Also, good luck to Paolo Campinotti. Thanks to the friendship with Stefano Domenicali, he managed to design the beautiful livery of this Desmo 16 Ducati. You will see this Ducati on the first race of MotoGP on March. We will be there as a Sky TV with the broadcasting. You can follow us on our channel 208, and we are, well, let's, I'll see you very, very soon. I would like to say goodbye to Mr. Guidotti, Francesco Bagnaia, and Jack Miller. Good luck to you all, guys. And I would like to hop on this bike, because I really want to ride a bike. Because when you ride, we are there commenting on the show, and we never ride a bike. So I'm really happy to be up here. Thank you.